I'm Brent Cobb. This is the band. We are in luck.
Door closed?
Yes, sir.
All right, let's do this thing. Tell us the name of the song and play that sucker.
This is Digging Holes. Well, I ought to be working in a coal mine, neck deep in black monk soot, swinging a pick at that mountainside, halfway to China. I think I would fit right in where the sun don't shine. She's better off alone. Yeah, I ought to be working in a coal mine. Lord knows I'm good at digging holes.
Do it.
Well, I ought to be drilling 40 black gold, swimming in the Texas tea. I can make a killing all on my own, selling my misfortune to a family. Cause when I hit rock bottom, the deeper down I go. Yeah, I ought to be good in 40 black gold. Lord knows I'm good at digging holes. Well, I ought to be working for the railroad, sweat pouring off my back, hauling away a heavy load. It's a far cry from here, down a coal strip track, and I can't take her with me. She better off without. Yeah, I ought to be working for the railroad. Lord knows I'm good at leaving town. When it comes to love, I ain't got a clue what this heart of mine is supposed to do. It tears me up inside when I put her through. Still she won't let go. Oh, I ought to make my living in a graveyard, over my head in dirt. If I had a shovel, I'd bury this heart 6 feet down. And my last word would be, I never meant to hurt you. I'm better off a ghost. Yeah, I ought to make my living in a graveyard. Lord knows I'm good at digging holes. Oh, I ought to make my living in a graveyard. Lord knows I'm good at digging holes. Thank you, sir.
The execution. Shit. I want to talk about that song and how it was conceived and where it came from.
Well, Digging Holes, I write on Music Row, like a lot of the greats, like Willie did, and write for a publishing company. I was writing with a guy named Casey Wood one morning. We'd never met before, and he was from West Virginia. And his brother, we were going through a hard time with our significant others. And he was telling his story about his brother, who is also a great musician, but he never decided to move to Nashville because he was pretty good at digging holes in the coal mines. And I let him tell the whole story. And we'd been talking about our wives, you know, and the positions we were in. And so when he got done telling that story, I was like, we're writing Digging Holes about that, you know? And so that's kind of where the song came from.
So it has a philosophical kind of thing. Yeah. It came out of it also real.
A little tongue-in-cheek, little, yeah. This is Jason Cott, Jay Cott, Michael Harris, old generic Steve Smith. We're Brent Cobb.
The drummer from Journey.
That's right. And we all live in Nashville, Tennessee. We're from all over the place. And glad to be here today.
How long have you been together?
Well, we haven't been playing very long together. I mean,
I've been with you a little more than a year,
months.
I think.
Yeah.
And the band's been together about 6-7 months.
Yeah. We really just dug in. We've been on the Nikki Lane tour with Jonathan Tyler, the Highway Queen tour. And we just did 25 dates with them in a row. And we We flew from Minneapolis, where it was 0 degree weather, and came here, and we haven't slept yet.
Was that yesterday?
It was yesterday.
It was yesterday.
How's your, so you haven't been together that long, but you sound like you're tight, you know? Did you know each other before you formed the band, or did you just kind of meet?
We didn't actually. Jay and I knew one another.
Yeah.
But, no, I toured for about 3 years, 3 or 4 years, not doing a whole lot, about 120 dates a year, and then I had a daughter, and I got to where I was spinning my wheels, and I just decided to just write and not tour for a while, and in the middle of that, I have a cousin who happens to be a really great producer, Dave Cobb. He produced Chris Stapleton and Sturgill Simpson, and Jason Isbell, just to name drop a few. And he called me in the middle of this break. I was never gonna go back out touring again. And he said, I'm putting together this concept record called Southern Family. And I thought it'd only be appropriate to have my little bitch ass cousin be a part of it. And so I said, okay. And I wrote a song. And then when we got back in the studio, we had not been in the studio together for 10 years. And it was like coming home. And so I did put out a record, and once I put that record out, Mike and I met. I don't want to tell a whole long story. You have to edit the hell out of this, I'm sure. But Mike is a promoter, and we met on this communion tour. And Mike was like, "Man, I play a little guitar." Like, I bet you do, buddy.
That's adorable. And,
that's real cute. And
bet you too, buddy.
And it turned out, where did we start playing? I was born in the Southland. Some 20 odd years ago. He did that shit, and I was like, all right, you do play.
Plays a little guitar.
Yeah,
a tiny one.
And a little bitty guitar. And then Mike and Steve used to play in a band called Apache Relay. And so it just kind of came together. Jay and I already knew one another.
So the three-part harmony thing, was that like something you were looking for, or it just happened?
I love harmony. My daddy's a musician, and all my uncles and such. I've just always loved harmony. So
it's, I can say the same, man. Yeah. I love it. It makes me happier than just about anything.
Too.
Yeah.
Hey, you must have grown up in church.
I studied voice in school.
Yeah. So, influences?
My biggest influence. They still play. I mean, what about y'all? What's your influences?
Man, it's so varied. I mean, I studied classical music, played the blues for a lot of years, played a lot of jazz music. Miles Davis is one of my biggest inspirations, but I love Bach. Hip-hop music, love soul music, from Detroit, Bob Seger, you know, all that.
Do you play an instrument?
I'm a bass player.
Oh, you're a bass player?
Yes, yeah, he's a bass guy. It's too bad we don't have one of those today.
Bass, yeah, man. We had to sell it to get here.
It's unfortunate.
Sorry, Ben.
Bass goes first, drum second.
That's right.
Yeah, as you see.
Steve's drums been minimized.
All we could afford. You know?
Sounds good.
Yeah.
So what do y'all think of this whole
reunion? Man, I am so proud to be here. Yes. I've wanted to be a part of this I've wanted to just come to Willie's place anyway for a long time. Actually, I did the Country Throwdown tour with Willie in 2010 or 2011. And I got to become friends with Lucas, and I'd bug Lucas every night. At the end of every night, I'd go, man, I sure would like to meet your daddy. And the last night of it was a 4th of July picnic, and finally Lucas introduced me to Willie, and man, it's so cool to be here. He's a huge influence.
It's amazing to look into Willie's eyes, man. They're deepest, darkest brown I've ever seen, and they're stone. I'm like, talking. I've done this with him like three times. One time I was like, he just finished playing for Leon Russell in Austin City Limits.
Yeah.
He said, wait for him in the dressing room, he'll come in, introduce him, and then he'll sit down, and we leave, come back in 15 minutes.
So we go way down the hall and we smell the pot, the strongest out of
it. For 15 minutes.
Yeah, and we go back in and he's got the big sleeves sitting there and it's just hitting his eye like in another country. And I'm thinking, you're not going to be able to keep it. And I said, great show. And he said, thank you. Pop him right in. Okay, all right. You're the awesome. Boss, man. Weed, whiskey, or both, or neither.
I like.
Cut.
There you go.
There's your answer.
Best answer ever, but weed.
Whiskey.
Weed.
We already covered that.
Yeah, man. Come on.
What are you?
Whiskey.
I'll do whiskey.
All right. Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
I really appreciate it.